Ready, Sharon? All right, thank you, everyone. Thank you for joining me at today's Select Board meeting on Tuesday, September 19th. I am opening the meeting at 5:48. Please stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thank you, everyone. As an announcement, the meeting is being recorded. And let's see, the first item on the agenda is executive session, but I believe that, Ryan, since this involves you, do you wish this to happen in open session?
Yes, sir.
All right. Let the record show that Ryan asked for this to be an open session, which is pretty obvious given the number of people here today. Let's see. All right, so. Let's see. So that everyone knows, at the table we have Michelle Randazzo, Town Counsel from KP Law. She will be here to make sure that I don't make any mistakes, since this is a since we want to make sure that we get this matter right, and that is the most important thing to me. All right, so the matter at hand is a complaint against a town employee. By one of the Select Board members, Brad Kudelski. That is why Brad is not up here today. He is here as a private citizen, and he will not be participating in the board's activities today to avoid any appearance of a conflict of interest. Specifically, the and Brad, rather than rep, and so our intention here today is fact finding. We are going to. Our hope is that we can understand what happened and, if possible, come to a amicable resolution among all the parties. If that is not possible, the intention of the, my intention is that any action would be deferred to a later meeting. We will not be deciding on any course of action that is not agreed to by all the parties involved. As I understand it, Ryan is entitled to counsel. Ryan, do you have counsel here next to you? All right, that's very well. My understanding is that your counsel is, you're entitled to counsel for advice, but the counsel will not represent you. You will be speaking for yourself. Is that consistent with how you expected to come in here? All right, good. All right. This is almost as bad as the dog hearing. All the formality and the and it's a little tense up here. So thank you.
Can I make a point of order?
I'm sorry. Yes, Mr. Kelleher, you have a point of order.
I don't know if I'm correct on this or not, but this was posted on the town website as an executive session, and would it be? I could be wrong, and I apologize if I am. But if we change it from executive session to a open session, doesn't that go against the open meeting law? Because, say, for example, myself, the only reason I knew it was possibly going to change tonight is because I got a message from Sarah. But an ordinary citizen in Brookfield wouldn't have that same opportunity, and they would have seen it on the website and said, hey, it's executive session, I'm not going to go. And we're changing it at the last minute to be not the executive session.
My understanding, and I could be wrong, is that the intention of the Select Board was to was schedule this as executive session so that it could be handled privately among the parties. Ryan, as is his right, has asked that we not hold that meeting in executive session. So, my understanding is until Ryan is here and waives executive session, there is no way for us to know that this meeting will be in, that this will be happen in open session. Michelle, did I get that right?
Yes, I mean, the person that's the subject can at any time request that it be held open. Even if we've already gone into executive session, they could choose midway through to say, you know what, I want this to be held open. And so under the open meeting law, that's
okay, not I just want to make sure, I wasn't sure, and I wasn't 100% sure. I just want to make sure that we weren't all missing something.
Yeah.
So.
And I don't.
That's sort of why it has to be opened in open session so that the public can actually witness.
All right, my apologies.
excuse me. Before we get started, the intention of the select board here is to speak to the parties involved. If you are not directly involved in the matter, we are not expecting to talk to you or hear from you. This is, we are not taking voices of support for any, we are not taking messages.
Public comment? We're not taking public comment.
We're not taking public comment of any form. We're, thank you.
Yep.
So, we'll be focusing on the subject of the complaint and the details that everyone involved with the complaint can share to help us understand and get to the bottom of what happened. So with that, I am intending to start with Brad Kadelski as the complainant. Brad, I would like you to come up, and if you could share with us the details of your complaint. I know you've given it to us in writing,
Okay. But
because we're in open meeting, it's like...
Should I summarize what I said, or should I read what I said?
I was going to say, I don't think you need to read it, but summarize it, and since you're here, if we need more detail coming up, if we need to come back for more detail or some clarification, we've got you here, and you can share it at that time.
Sure. Yep. So, it all kind of started with the August 24th meeting of the select board when Mr. Holcraft had come up to me and wanted to know why I told the highway department the issue with his reported cell phone. And I told him at that point, at 100% that I would never have brought his name in. I didn't bring his name in. And during the meeting, we would find out what happened and how I came into this information. At that point, I stated what the information was. Mr. Holcraft stated after the meeting that he would again continue to talk to me, which I think everyone here was witness to how that went down. Mr. Pompriant was there for the whole meeting, knew that this exchange was going to happen after the meeting. Never had any comment about it, and then continued to leave the meeting as I was approached by Mr. Holcraft about what was said. Since then, I've been dealing with the issues of the yellow sign, as we refer to it. My children are dealing with it at school, all over something that I never even said or did. I mean, really, the cell phone came down to something that I found with Kelly when it was reported to me about a side business that he was operating. And I was questioned whether it was legal. I talked to Kelly whether there was any issue with him having a side business. She didn't believe there was, but what we did notice was his cell phone that was being used by the highway. And okay.
I understand the cell phone's a subject of the complaint.
Yeah.
But it's like, can we just say you received a report about Brian's cell phone, and that there was some, and just move on from that rather than going into the details.
Sure.
Because I don't think that's entirely relevant.
All right. So Mr. Holcraft obviously had that exchange with me. I said there was no reason for Ryan to have brought up your name in that conversation. I've had no issue with Mr. Holcraft to any degree to why I would bring him into that conversation. I know he's got the yellow sign. He's the last person I want to have involved with anything. So, and since then, what's transpired, you know, with my children in the school, with this yellow sign and the ongoing harassment, I guess I would say, over something that I never did.
Okay, and then I didn't hear it clearly, so could you please explicitly tell us what you believe Ryan did that you are complaining about?
And I could be completely wrong here, but from the statements that Mr. Holcraft said, Ryan called him and said that I was accusing Mr. Holcraft of bringing all this information forward.
Okay, so that would be that. I'm trying to think of the right way to say this that positions it correctly. But you believe that Ryan told Mr. Holdcraft that you raised his name as the source of the information, and you say, and you contend that you did no such thing. Is that
correct?
Is that accurate?
And Ryan was here when that was all going down and made no comment about that.
Okay.
As I was defending.
So in your opinion, he allowed an untrue statement to stand?
Correct.
And potentially made a false statement to an individual, to a citizen of the town regarding information that was not necessarily...
Correct.
Okay. You will be allowed to talk, Ryan. We're going to start. It's like you and Brad would get a chance to talk, and then if we feel we need to hear from anyone else to confirm details that one of you two has said, we will bring them in, and then at that point when we think we've heard from everyone, we'll see where we go from there. All right. No, but it's a fair question, right? I just want to make sure everyone knows where I'm intending this to go. All right. Let's see. I think that's it. I think that's a starting point. If we need more information, Brad,
yeah,
we'll bring you back. All right, Ryan? How are you doing, Ryan?
I've been better.
I share that feeling. I've had better Tuesdays, too.
Yeah.
All right, so... I guess I will, I will ask you to, respond to Brad's complaint. Specifically, I would like you to, as much as possible, limit yourself to what you heard, what you saw, and what you said. And if you have anything that you feel is a conclusion or a supposition, you can share those if you qualify them as such. Like, for example, they lied to me is a conclusion. Saying they said this and I thought it was a lie I could have been a lawyer in another life. But it's go ahead and respond.
Tell you my side of the story.
Sure.
I did call Brad on the 23rd, and that was for a number of reasons. It wasn't just about the cell phone. There was other things going into the selectmen's meeting that I wanted to discuss with him. Basically, the whole conversation went by. I think we were on the phone for 18 minutes, and at the last minute or two, he said, "Is there anything else?" And I said, "Yeah, one more thing." And I said, is the thing about a cell phone on the agenda, is that about mine?" And he said, "Yeah, it came to my attention and all that." And what I said was, "I'd like to know where that came from. Who's that coming from?" And he said, "I can't tell you that." So I asked him a second time, "Who did that come from? I really feel like it's my right to know who this was." And he said the same thing again. And then I pressed him a third time. And he said, "I think it had something to do with Holdcraft." And that is the truth. That's how it went. In fact, I ended up being on the phone with Rich Chafee shortly afterwards. He was planning on helping us get the concrete out of the pit, and I told him that we wouldn't need him at that point. So I gave him the whole story while we were on the phone, and the story was the same, and I even got my phone records. Oh, and another thing is, I asked him if he thought I should call Holdcraft to just get to the bottom of it, you know, confront it head on, like if he had anything to do with the phone issue. And he said, "Yeah, you should probably call him." So I did. And you can see here, these are my phone records. You can take a look at it.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Is that two copies?
Yeah.
Oh.
There's two copies there. So basically, if that was never said to me, I wouldn't have called Holdcraft.
Mm-hmm.
I would have no reason to. And he has two different numbers, and I called both. So,
mm-hmm.
You know, I just wanted to get to the bottom of it, and that's where it started. And then the point to the Selectmen's meeting, well, I was coming in here for a few other issues that I was a little nervous about, and I wasn't about to confront one of my bosses at the, before the meeting even started about this issue. So that's why I didn't say a thing. So.
Okay, but you maintain that, let's see, the quote I have from you is, you maintain that Brad said, I think it had to do something with Holdcraft.
Had something to do with Holdcraft.
Okay.
Yeah. So another thing that I'd like to say is, I thought we just passed a policy that all complaints are in writing, and I'm still interested to know who the person that brought this to everyone's attention about my phone and about my side business. I'd still like to know that too.
I believe that complaint is more against a person's behavior, and I would have to look into it, Ryan. My gut feeling is that the complaint about your phone is not a, Kelly, the complaint policy we raised, that was more intended around personal behavior. Do you remember we have a policy that complaints have to be in writing?
The policy is not in any way specific as to personal behavior. The policy says that all complaints
here it is.
Come through the select board.
And in writing.
And in writing to care.
Did that complaint come in prior or after we voted the policy?
This issue is after this was passed.
What was the date?
6/29.
Yeah, I was going to say, that policy wasn't the end of August. So I unless someone has evidence to the contrary, I'm comfortable with saying that that policy was in effect at the time. And I mean, I would say whether or not, I don't know. Ryan, I don't know. I would have to think about it. I don't see it as a, I see that being more important when it's a report of someone's behavior and something that can't be objectively determined. And in my mind, the situation with your phone is more of an objective thing, not of their behavior on this time at this date was rude and threatening, and I thought they were going to hit me, which to me is a different kind of complaint than a the paperwork is wrong or there's something going on.
Mr. Chair, may I give you some input?
Yeah, I'm loving that, Beth, since I need to stop talking.
Okay, so. Ryan, I think the first thing is that I do want a quick consult from the town council. From my understanding of what was communicated on the night of the 24th, whenever our last select board meeting was that regardless of the source of the information, so I just want to clear something up here. Regardless of the source of the information, because quite frankly, I know that's what this meeting is about, right? I think the challenge that we were facing with the cell phone information is a potential for a conflict between the practice that we had been engaged in from a perspective of the town and what was legal for us to pay for, right? So the decision, the question at hand that evening was not around, gee, for whatever reason, we don't want to pay for this guy's cell phone, or it's not whether it's okay to have a side business or what have you. That was pretty much off the table. The foundational issue is that as a public entity, we were put in a position where someone had alerted us to the fact that something we were paying for also could be viewed as supporting a private entity, right? Without any type of contractual relationship with that entity. So
yeah,
I'm
not arguing that part.
Right, and the information at that point, my primary concern, right, was that accountant is now aware of it, however it came to light, right? And it's not even a complaint against you, it's a statement of fact. Cell phone, currently paid for by town, associated with private business, okay?
For 4 years.
Okay, so we could, if we wanted to talk about from a character perspective, cell phone leveraged as part of a hiring package, not revealed at the time it was already associated with a side business. We don't want to go into that conversation this evening.
I didn't have a side business when I started.
Okay, great. So that's a great piece of information to have. So was the 4 years, 4 years that you've been with the town for the, or 4 years that it's been that the private business
that
is associated with the cell phone?
I've had a business shortly after I got hired.
So, decisions were made, actions were taken. It came to the town's awareness late. It probably should have been brought to the town's awareness by you when the business was started up and associated with that cell phone.
I don't think there's a conflict there, but okay.
Okay. So.
But we are where we are now.
But we are where we are now. I just want to make sure we kind of lay out that timeline.
That's fine.
Associated with that activity.
I'm just simply going to say that as the appointing authority or as supervisors, we all have obligations if we become aware of the situation and we investigate it, we review it, it seems to be an issue, that it would be imprudent to say we have to have something in writing from somebody out there in the world before we can act on it, right? And so this is just it is a little bit different in quality and kind than the type of complaints that I suspect your complaint policy was intended to address, right? Where either third parties or even other town employees against, other employees where it's not your actual boss that's coming to you and saying, hey, we have an issue, we think there's a problem here, we'd like to talk to you about that.
But that's not how this went. This was put on an agenda and it was never even brought to my attention up front. Like, I don't come into meetings and drop bombshells on you guys. So I was just kind of curious to hear about it first before the meeting.
Mm-hmm.
But that's maybe we're getting sidetracked, but that's where I was coming from, asking the questions.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Understood. Do you have any more questions for Ryan? All right. Ryan, do you have anything else you'd like to share?
No.
All right. Thank you for now. Brad, you have something?
I wanted to bring up, in that 24th meeting.
Come up to the table. Because there is some discrepancy between how you've related your conversation with Ryan and how Ryan has related that conversation. So I was intending to give you the opportunity to speak to that and anything
sure.
else you wanted to do.
On the 24th meeting, and if people want to look through the tapes, I said exactly how I came into this information.
Mm-hmm.
And it was because it all started months back when someone at a bar started slandering Mr. Pompriant about his side business. I ignored it up until a couple months back when I came across a Facebook posting of this advertisement for the business, which I then brought to Kelly's attention and questioned Kelly about it. And she questioned, how do I know this is Ryan's business? She wanted me to look at the website with me and the Facebook. And that's when it was noticed and discovered his cell phone being used for those businesses. There was no complaint, nothing from Mr. Holcraft. It was all disclosed at that meeting how that information was discovered.
So how did you become aware that of the issue of the concern with Ryan's town his cell phone paid for completely by the town being used in a side business? Was that raised to you by someone else, or is that
no? That was something I discovered with Kelly.
Okay, so if I may, so the other person, you used the word slandering Ryan's business, so they were, I'm going to guess they were not thinking very favorably of it, but
no.
It had nothing to do with it. Did it have anything to do with the cell phone?
It had nothing to do with the cell phone.
Okay, so it's just, but in an, okay.
it had more to do with the business, and when I saw it, it made me question to Kelly, is this something legal? Is this an issue? And she, at that time, said, granted, the optics aren't looking good, but there's nothing prohibits him from running this business.
Okay. So the...
The issue came up when we were trying to verify this website, and his cell phone number that was paid for by the town was being listed.
So what were you doing investigating Ryan's business on the web?
I wasn't investigating it.
Well, you were looking at his website, so...
No. Someone told me about the business.
Right.
When I was on Facebook, going through my feed, there was something that someone shared about his business, and that's how I saw it. No one gave me this information. I stumbled across it and went to Kelly with it.
And how did you know that phone number was Ryan's?
Because Kelly told me it was Ryan's. And I know it's Ryan's. I mean, I confirmed that it was Ryan's.
Okay.
I think a number of the town employees have the highway superintendent's cell phone number. I think it might even be posted on our website. Mm-hmm.
I don't know that the cell phone is posted. Okay. But it was in my phone.
Yeah.
And it's in my phone, too. I mean, I was able to confirm it myself.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't realize that his cell phone was being paid 100% by the town. I knew we paid a portion of it. But again, no reason why I would... This was all on my own discovery. To ever bring Dave Holcraft into this, to me, is a method of... I mean...
Okay. So, I mean, so specifically, Ryan said... Ryan attributed to you... the third that he asked you a third time, and you said, "I think it had to do something with Holdcraft." Did you say that?
No.
Okay. That's fine. That's okay.
I have no intent or reason to.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Okay. All right. Anything else?
That's it.
All right. Thank you. Ryan, do you have anything else you'd like to add now that Brad's added more detail, or do you just stand on what you've said? Yeah, if you have something to say, please come up. Just to make sure the microphone captures it.
I just want to point out the fact that I usually never call Dave Holdcraft. He calls me with issues pertaining to the highway department or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So why else would I have called him?
It's kind of funny because I was about to ask what the rest of your phone log looks like to see if
I don't talk to him daily. If he calls me, I answer it. He does call my cell phone, and that's what it's for. And I don't call him. He calls me more than like 98% of the time. And if I call him, it's probably returning a missed call from him.
Mm-hmm.
So for me to call him three times in a row, I don't know. I mean, that's what I'm going on.
Yep. Just bang, bang, bang. When you call him.
Oh, I wanted to get to the bottom of it. I don't, you know, I wanted to know.
Okay.
So,
all right.
Yeah, that's all I got.
All right, thank you. Do you think we need to hear from anyone else?
Well, the only other party in the room that has information, I guess, would be Mr. Holcraft himself as to what transpired in the phone conversations between himself and Ryan during the calls that are indicated on the log.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me, that was the first call that Ryan made.
Okay. Hold on. All right. Mr. Holdcraft, would you come up? I would like you to confirm for the record that that Ryan did tell you that with what
could content
I guess Mr. Holdcraft, could you recall for us the details of your phone conversation with Ryan? About 8 p.m. on August 23rd.
Yep, I missed a few calls from him. I don't know if he called me or I called him. We hooked up around 8 o'clock. And he kind of jumped down my throat a little bit saying, hey, what are you calling Brad complaining about my cell phone for? And I'm like, I don't even know anything about his cell phone. I knew nothing about his cell phone. So I said, who said that? And he said, Brad said that you complained about his phone. You know, I complained to Brad about his phone. And I said, it's a total lie. I said, here we go again, another selectman bashing me again. And I was outraged, and I'm still outraged about it. And I told him, I said, if I got a complaint with you, I always call him. If I see a pothole or if a road needs replowing, I always call him direct on his cell phone and tell him. I don't go run into you guys. I just tell him, and then he always addresses it, you know. Then I've been talking to Brad back and forth, and it was two Saturdays ago, I guess.
Mr. Holcraft?
Yes.
The matter at hand is specifically the complaint against Brad, so...
That's correct.
If you can help me, I'm sorry, the complaint by Brad against Ryan.
That's right.
So...
But it's all corroborative to the matter.
All right, go ahead.
So I spoke to Brad several times, and I called him and says, hey, what are you doing, you know, bringing my name into it? And he said, I didn't do it. I says, Ryan pressed me three times, and finally, Brad said, yeah, it was, Brad said, yeah, okay, I threw your name out there under the pressure and all that. I did throw your name out there. I said, well, why would you do that, you know? And I said, I'm going to have a hearing. I want this brought forward to the board. This is not going to stand. And as you know, I tried getting a hearing. I was in here ranting and raving, and I was outraged. And then me and Brad had several other conversations in reference to it. And he said he was going to make sure we got he's going to put a complaint in so we could have a hearing. And here we are.
Okay.
So, and I'm outraged that, you know, my name again is being bashed by one of the elected officials in this town. You know, I've had it up to here. So, and I should have gotten an executive letter here, by the way, too. Because I'm much in this thing as the other two are. You know, so you should have sent me a letter. Well, that's what I feel.
Okay.
So. All right, thank you.
I figured you'd be here anyway.
Yeah, that's not the way the law reads.
Michelle, could you address who gets the letter when it's
the subject of the complaints gets the letter you're talking about? They're the only people that actually get it.
Well, we got an elected official who lied about me.
Right.
So.
Thank you. But unfortunately, the board has limited authority over its own members. The members of the board are elected by the town, and we answer the town. So
yeah, I know. I'm very well aware of that.
All right.
Okay.
I'm
just getting sick of the lying that goes on in this town at this table.
All right. I don't think anyone else has any direct knowledge.
Everything else is hearsay.
Bearing on this. Yeah.
Even that was hearsay, actually.
I would say. I'd say Dave's entitled to say what he heard from Ryan. It's like,
I think at this point, right, there's not a dispute. I mean, there's a dispute between the Selectmen version and Ryan's version, but there's not a dispute that it was related to Mr. Holcraft by Ryan. So I don't know how much further down that path.
Yeah.
Yeah. I would say that, let's see. I would say that I've not heard any discrepancies between what Ryan and Dave's.
The fundamental discrepancy right now is what Ryan is saying, or Mr. Portgrant is saying, regarding the end content of the phone, original phone call between himself and Brad, Mr. Gadowski, and what Mr. Gadowski is saying. So it really fundamentally is a he said, is what we got.
Unfortunately, yes.
I understand it. Okay.
If you let Rich speak, he could corroborate the nature of the conversation.
between yourself and him.
Yeah, and it was right after me and Brad got on the phone.
I was the first one he spoke to.
Right.
But I would,
No comments from public, right?
I would.
That's not considered a comment.
Ryan, I would say that there is no, your.
The only information he has is your rendition of the events that have transpired on the phone call.
Yeah. And that.
And the fact that I asked him to make the call to Holcraft and the phone records.
Okay, and enough, please. Mr. Chafee, if we need to hear from you, we'll ask you to participate, but if we allow you to talk, then other people are going to feel that they're allowed to talk also. And given the number of people in the room, that's going to make this go.
There are no other people in the room. Phone conversation.
That's fine, but other people may have other things that from talking to Ryan. Fundamentally, the course.
So I need to overstep. Would you like me to weigh in?
Of course. Thank you, Michelle.
Again, I think the issue, there isn't a dispute. I don't think anybody's questioning Ryan's relay of the course of events. And so I don't know that we need additional people to corroborate that. I don't think that's the focus, at least as I'm hearing. What I'm hearing is it's a difference between the two versions of that initial discussion between Brad and Ryan.
Mm-hmm. Brad, did you want to say anything else?
Yes. So, back to the point of me even accusing anyone of saying anything was, I just want to reiterate that it was me that found that information with Kelly. So I'm not going to change my blame over into someone else, being Mr. Holcraft. There's no reason for me to do that. It was myself that found that information. And I wasn't going to tell him that it was me. I told him we would discover this in the meeting, and I shared all that information in that August 24th meeting.
Mm-hmm. May I approach that table again, please, Mr. Chairman?
Why, Mr. Holcraft?
Because I have something pertinent that I would like to say before this board.
Something new?
Something I think you need to hear. Maybe you weren't listening to me very clear when I spoke earlier. So I'd like to approach the table. And you're not afraid of the truth, are you?
No, I'm not. But good. I'm also not easily goaded into letting you up there. Excuse me, Mr. Holcraft. Just trying to say you're not afraid of the truth to put me in a position where I'm either saying no because I'm afraid of the truth or I have to let you up here is a cheap tactic. Not surprising, but cheap. So,
not in this town, it's not.
Please allow me to finish and make my decision, and then you can tell me that I'm afraid of the truth. All right? Let me finish.
I am.
Okay,
finish.
Good. All right. You have 1 minute to remind us of what you said earlier. Or is it new? Is it new, or you want to remind us of something you said earlier? Since you said I wasn't paying attention.
I want to refresh what I said to make sure you people were very clear of what I said.
Okay.
I don't think you heard.
Please come up and refresh our memory.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
I made it very clear, or maybe I did not make it clear, when I spoke to Brad, he spoke to me on the phone 2 Saturdays ago, mm-hmm. He finally admitted to me that he did put my name out there. Brad's mm-hmm. Brad, he said mm-hmm. that it was my name to Ryan.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, right. He admitted that he said my name to Ryan. Right. So, make sure you understand that. Right.
Thank you. Brad, would you care to respond to Mr. Holcraft's refresher of what he said?
Sure. It's in the letter because Ryan was bringing up people's names to flesh out who it was, who I wouldn't tell him. And one of the people that he brought up was Dave Holcraft. And I said, maybe it was, maybe it wasn't. I even referred to it in that letter. and said, we'll be talking about it in tonight in the select board meeting.
Okay, so hold on.
So what you're saying is that fundamentally, by when he was repeatedly stating that it must have been a reaction to Holcraft, because of course this body wouldn't do anything unless it came from Mr. Holcraft, because he's our fourth selectman, right? That you responded in a what could be considered a somewhat nebulous manner, and so from his own assumption bias, Mr. Pointbrand decided that that was the answer because of the way that you framed his conversation. You know, it could have been, sure, it could have been him, could have been anybody, maybe not. You're going to find out at the meeting. And he didn't like that answer, so then he contacted Mr. Holcraft.
Thank you. Ryan, would you come up for a quick moment? Brad's characterization of the conversation with you is a little different than what you said. Do you think? Do you stand by your recollection, or
I do.
Okay, thank you. I want to give you a chance to respond to that and confirm that you feel that the wording you shared with us earlier is the accurate recollection.
Yeah, I did not go and throw names out there because that wouldn't have been one of them anyway. Mm-hmm. Because literally, if he has a problem with anything going on with the roads or any, he's calling me directly. Mm-hmm. So that's why I would not have came up with that name. And then I got my phone records I wouldn't have gone and called him for any other reason.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I'm sticking to.
Okay. All right. Thank you. All right. There are a couple ways this could have ended really easily, and this is not one of them. Unfortunately, we have at this point we have contradicting testimony. Beth, is there anything else you think we should hear? Because I don't want to waste people's time.
I don't know that we have anything else pertinent to hear.
Yeah, I don't think so either. Our intention of this meeting is for the select board to learn and understand the details and everyone's take of what happened of everyone involved. Our intention is to not take any action tonight with regards to the complaint against Ryan. That is something that we will have to consider at a future meeting, and the purpose for that is was simply to make tonight a just the facts, ma'am, kind of meeting, and decisions will be made later. So,
can I ask a quick question? I'm just curious, who determines the outcome of this meeting tonight?
The outcome of this meeting, in terms of actions taken, there will be no actions taken as a result of this meeting tonight. The select board will discuss and convene and discuss this at a meeting at a future date, and at that point, actions may be taken, and that meeting will be posted, and it will be on the agenda.
Mr. Kudowski will not be part of that.
And yes, as an interested party, Mr. Kudowski, I expect will continue to recuse himself from that portion of the meeting. That was a fair question. Thank you for asking. I thought I covered it, but I don't always. Is there anything else that we've done here, unfortunately?
Well, it's the only thing on the agenda.
It is. All right, Brad and Ryan, since you are the subject and object of the complaint, is there anything else that you would like to bring to our attention before we close this meeting?
Yeah.
Go ahead. It's
another thing that I addressed in the letter was the town's whistleblower policy, which again would be a reason that I wouldn't tell someone who did some, you know, who made a complaint, even though I was the person that was actually making the complaint. I guess maybe I should have written the complaint, but I was the one that found the information with the cell phone.
Mm-hmm.
And according to the whistleblower policy, I would be in trouble if I ever was to bring up the issue of a complaint to someone in this nature. Just more of my facts to why I wouldn't bring this up.
Okay. Ryan, is there anything in Brad's statement that you want to respond to, or are you good? Okay, that's fine. I didn't think you would, but I think it's important as the object of the complaint. I want to make sure that anytime someone says something, you have an opportunity to respond. I don't want you to feel that you did not get your chance to have your say. This is too important to make that stupid mistake. You're welcome. All right. Let's see. I am going to take advantage of just having town council here. Just with regards to, for future reference, is there any rule against a whistleblower outing themselves as the source of a complaint?
No, but that's why you have whistleblower protection, so they want to out themselves.
I understand. Yeah. I just want to understand the rules. And since you're here, and I have you so convenient.
Well, you can't stop anybody from, you know, saying anything about themselves.
Right. That's what I thought. Okay. Right, I'll remember that for future reference. All right. Then. I think I do.
Can I ask a question?
I will take the question, but I don't promise to answer it.
Is that tape going to be available for people to look at? And is that letter available for people to look at?
The letter is a matter of public record. It's part of the meeting, and therefore it should be made available. The recording of the meeting, right now, the meeting recordings are being uploaded to the town's YouTube channel. We are working towards getting the public access cable TV channel working where it could be played there. But right now, YouTube is the only option. And I believe, Kelly, these meeting recordings are subject to open meeting requests, right? So if it's posted to YouTube, we can just point them to it, right?
Correct.
Okay. So, yeah, so did that answer your question?
Yes.
Okay, good. Yes, I think we have been trying to get those up. I don't know where we are on getting those up.